Hi guys, welcome to Tactical Combat System. In today's video, I will show you how you can access, how you can deploy your weapons, fire weapons or blades, in the case, in the situation in which you carry a tactical bag with you. In the situation in which I don't have a tactical bag with me, I will carry my weapons like I show you also in the preview videos in the next way. So I have my fire weapon in the appendix position. I want to repeat that I am carrying now and I am using for training airsoft replica, even if it's an airsoft replica, treat it like a real weapon. Don't put the finger inside on the trigger, inside the guard. Check the magazine. In this case, we don't have a magazine. Check inside for on the chamber room. Treat all the weapons like they are real. So we come back. I am having the handgun in appendix position, in this case with a minimalist holster for the trigger guard. I have on the belt a fixed blade, a small fixed blade. On the lateral, on the part of the weak hand, I have a tactical pen. And on the right side, I have a folder, a non-automatic folder. So in case that I have the tactical bag with me and I must access my weapon, the movement is in this way. One of my hand is going up and the other one is pushing the bag already. Yeah? So I, with the strong hand, I push the bag, the other is going up. From this position, I must take the clothes up. Yeah. So I come with the weak hand catching my clothes, take it up, the other strong hand is going on the gun, I liberate the gun and coming on the target. So you must understand that in a real situation, when I must access my weapon, I will not remain in the same position. Like I say also in my previous videos, you must move. A target that is fixed is a dead target. So if I identify the threat in front of me and I want to access my weapon, I want the gun move from that position. Because if I remaining in the same place, my reaction, it will be normally more slow than the action, and the bad guy already is identifying me like a target. So I move all the time my axe. In this case, when I want to pass from the tactical pen to the fire weapon, it's the same. I have already my hand catching on the tactical pen. I am hitting the target. I am moving back and I'm making the same movement. When I hit the target, already my strong hand, it's pushing the bag. Yeah. And my hand with the tactical pen is catching the material, the clothes on me. The other strong hand is going on the gun and I am deploying it and ready to use my gun. Of course, in this situation, when I create the distance, we talk about big distance. I am exiting from the camera. I am remaining here so you can see better how I make the movements. So again, I'm hitting, pushing, deploying the weapon and ready to use my fire weapon. I am all the time twisting a little bit my body. So if I am, for example, in this position and I have the target in front of me, the target, it will see that I am catching my tactical pen, yeah? So this is visible. But if I am twisting myself in this position, it's more difficult to understand what I am making. So I am catching the tactical pen. I am taking it up, hitting it with it. Just a moment. Hitting. In that moment, this hand is pushing my back. It's coming the other hand that is catching the closest. The strong hand is taking the gun out and I'm coming with it on the target. I can make a grip coming with two fingers and the tactical pen down, trying to maintain the normal one. Or the hand is coming on the chest and I'm using the fire weapon only with one hand. So if I have the handgun now in my tactical bag, and I need to make the same technique, so I have the tactical pen here, I am hitting, it's the same concept, I am hitting, I am going back, in the moment in which I am going back, I am catching, I am entering with my hand in the space where my gun it is, I am catching the gun, take it out and be ready to use it for firing. I repeat, if you train every day or often by deploying your weapon from the appendix position, but you don't train by deploying from the tactical bag, and you will go one day carrying like this, and in that day something will happen, the chances that you will deploy your weapon fast and to be ready to use it in a stress condition and all these other factors that will influence your reaction, it's very wrong. So train if you use like this, and then apply it in real situation if it will happen. So if I have the tactical bag with me, I will choose, for example, of course, training is required. Not I'm training all the time to have the folder and to deploy it from my strong side, from the pocket. And now I will put it in the bag and I expect tomorrow to be able to deploy it in a real condition, in a real situation. So after training, or you can apply it also in your training, you take the knife, for example, and you can put it on the interior of the bag. For example, here I have a pocket, but I clip it outside in such a way that it's looking like this. But in this situation, already the knife, it's prepared for being used. For example, if I have a target in front, if I have if I'm identifying some threats, and I'm making this movement on the pocket, yeah. For example, when I'm making now with the tactical pen, my targets see my movement, and they can understand that I want to deploy a weapon. But here I have my tactical bag, here I have my zippers, so I'm not making this to put the hand that I'm taking something. I'm only with the hand putting in this position on the bag, and this hand, the strong hand, it's already accessing it with the hand on the knife, yeah? Already is catching, it's here, catching the knife. So in the situation in which something is going wrong, this hand can go to hit, or if it's not hitting and I want only to deploy, it's catching the bag, I'm taking the knife out and I am ready to use it. I'm here, I need to deploy the knife, I'm with the hand already on it, it's not seeing, it's not like in this kind of position where I put the hand on it. I'm having it on the already prepared, I'm exiting and ready to use the knife. I identify the targets, I already take my position, catching already, I'm with the hand on the knife already. When I need to operate it, I'm already deploying it and use it. In the situation of a fixed blade, is the same. We attach the holster of the blade on the interior pocket. You have the hand there. If you need to use it already, you are ready to use very fast and very efficient in these kind of situations in which you don't want the targets to identify that you are deploying your weapons. Yeah. If, for example, for the fixed blade that I'm carrying on the belt, I choose to carry it there and I have my tactical bag with me, in the situation in which I must use that weapon, I will do the same mechanism like it was the handgun. So I must push or drag the bag in such a way that I can access the knife. Here, it will be more complicated. In this situation, it's not hard because I don't have a lot of weight in the bag, so I can go directly. But if you have a lot of weight in your bag, this movement and this weight here, it will stop you to be fast, and maybe it will block you for deploying your weapon. So it's better if I must use it to give it back, catch the t-shirt, take the knife out and begin to use it. So again, I'm here. I'm here. Of course that you can choose, for example, to wear your bag, put a reverse and to be like a normal one. So when you want to access your weapon, you don't need any more this kind of movement, because already your waistband it's free, so you can access very fast your weapon. But many times maybe you need the bag, yeah? For example, you need to put it, you have it in front of you, because in that moment you need, for example, to take something from it, yeah? Things that you have there and you must access. So if you have it in front of you, and in this moment when it's in front, it's happening something, you must be ready to take out the bag and be ready to use your tools. Also, if, for example, many times I'm wearing the tactical bag in this position because I have things inside like the medical kit and other stuff, and if I need it immediately, I can access it immediately. So these kind of techniques that I was showing you before, they are applying only in the situation in which you choose to carry your bag like this, yeah, like now. You must understand that in every aspect that you decide to implement it in your daily training or in your daily carry, everything has pluses and minuses. So in this situation also, the bad part to have a tactical bag like this and wear it here is that if you decide to have the handgun and you are wearing it in the appendix position, you must have a movement in plus to deploy your weapon. The same if I have the fixed blade here and I must deploy it. The good parts are that I can conceal, like the tactical pen here, on my bag, or the knife, I can conceal it better in such a way that I not show this kind of movement with the hand, and my targets are not identifying that I can take a knife or a tool from my pocket. So here it's looking more natural, I can speak. And also, before to take the knife, if it's not a situation in which I must use in that moment the knife, my hands already are in a position in which I can protect myself, cover myself, and do other stuff like this. If I have the time to identify the threat, I'm already with the hand on the knife. Take it out, open it, and be ready to use. So all the time, analyze the advantages or the bad parts of implemented that thing in your daily carry. Another very important aspect of your training is the clothes that you wear. Train with the clothes, try to see if you are wearing this jacket that every day you are wearing, if you can access your weapon, if it's close, like in this position, if you can access the weapon to deploy your weapon, if you can access it fast. This is meaning that you wear your jacket, you wear your gun. For sure it will not be like in the same condition like when you have only a t-shirt, but it's the same idea, yeah? I'm trying to see if making the movement in this jacket, it's permitting me to deploy the weapon and to use it. Okay guys, thank you very much for watching this video. Don't forget, if you like the content, subscribe to my channel, and if you have other ideas about other kind of topics that you want me to make videos about it, let a comment in the section below. Thank you very much.